Hey, what is going on, guys? Welcome back to another video on the channel. In today's video, I'm doing something a little bit different. So, obviously, Team of the Year votes is currently occurring, and I thought I might as well make a video on my personal favourite players of the year and the players I'm going to vote for this year. So, going into the first one, there are a lot of decent keepers that I think deserve applause. Oblak, obviously, a legend of the game, legend of the goalkeeping game. Edouard Mendy, been playing very well in the Premier League. Controversy of which goalkeeper is better, him or Ramsdale at the moment. I would say it's very close. Edison, obviously, another great one. Courtois, Donnarumma, Mignon, I haven't really seen. Martinez, he's obviously good, but I don't think I want to vote for him. So to start off, I think, having watched him throughout the Euros, not only throughout the Euros, but also seeing what he's done with PSG, I think there's no doubt in my mind that it has to be Gianluigi Donnarumma that gets that goalkeeping position. So now we move on to the defenders. Now, this is a pretty big one. So I'm going to base this off both what I want to see in FIFA 22 and a mixture of who I think deserves it. So if there's a player who I want to see their card in FIFA, but I don't think necessarily deserves it, I will mention that. Okay, I see an instant one that I want to stick right in there at left back, and that is João Cancelo. He's been incredible for Manchester City as of recent. Why is Romero in here? Why is Romero in here? He's been awful. Some of the decisions of who they've included is questionable. Like, why is Trippier in here? No one's voting for Trippier, are they? Right, so with João Cancelo at left back, I guess that leaves us with the centre back positions to decide. I think Antonio Rudiger deserves a shout for centre back. Is he the best centre-back, one of the best centre-backs in the world? No. Has he played well this year? Yes. So, bearing that in mind, I think he has to go in there. This team of the year this team of the year will be very good. I think it'll be stupid, because half these players just don't deserve team of the year cards. Like, they're good players in their own right, but you just don't deserve it. So I'm going to put Hakimi and Hernandez just because I have no idea who else to put in there. Right, we have a lot of good players here. This one is one that I quite like. Personally, it is one of my favourites. Interesting that Son's been put in midfielders. I guess they're putting wide midfielders. And then, some of these are wingers, so I don't quite know why that's... I guess he might be a left mid as opposed to a left wing, but that's the same thing in this game. Right, so what do I want to see here? Well, judging I have a few of these players in my starting 11, I definitely want to see, not only because I want to see him in the game, but also because he's played so well in the Premier League, and he's just an icon of the Premier League game at the moment. Kevin De Bruyne, I'm going to definitely be giving him one of those midfielder spots. Alongside him, a bit of a biased one, not really got a reason for it. He's had some decent games. Decent string of matches. I mean, it's very rare that you see him. He's got 7.4 foot mob rating. So, yeah, I think Leon Goretzka plays incredibly, no matter what team he's playing in. And this is the bit where I'm stuck, because I can't quite think of who I want to give this last slot to. Now, this slot's obviously going to be to the slot that most players have in their team. If I see someone like Bruno Fernandes in there, I'm going to be fuming. If I see someone like Phil Foden in there, I'm going to be fuming, because he just simply does not deserve it. So I think I'm going to stick Son in there. By being an Arsenal fan, I think Son... pure quality. And here we go, arguably some of the most important positions on the pitch, if not the most important positions on the pitch. And obviously we all know Mohamed Salah, he's going in the middle. Actually no, we'll stick him out on the right. Mohamed Salah, been incredible. this year at the moment. He's rocking a 4.0, an 8.0, I mean. So yeah, because he's got a score of 8.0 on Footbin, and he's always at a foot mob, and he's scored a decent amount of goals recently. A record of in 20 matches, he scored 17 goals and got 7 assists. There's just no doubt in my mind that Karim Benzema deserves a place in the team. Right. Now it's time for a tough decision. Who do I want in here? This could be the first year where we see a team of the year without Messi and Ronaldo for a long time. Without either of them. But personally, I don't think there's a definitive player here who I want to put in. I'm just going to go with the Ronaldo fanboy and stick Ronaldo in at left wing. Some of these are biased, some of these aren't actually based on my pure belief, and I'm sure a lot of you guys will be unhappy about that, and I understand that completely. Personally, I have tried to be fair with a few of them. Donnarumma, I think, Rudiger, Cancelo. I think Hakimi's been playing well, I think. Goretzka's always playing well. Son's playing well. De Bruyne's playing well. Salah, Benzema. Only two or three, maybe, that might not deserve to be in there. But obviously, for personal reasons, I decided, yeah, I'm going to give them my vote. So, with that, I'm going to submit my vote. And, yeah, my vote has been submitted. I would love to see your guys' votes, or what you guys decided to put them down in the comment section down below. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you are new here, leave a like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next episode. Good. It's